Team Sport TV. We're here with Randy Garcia, the father of Jake, and at the NIL event for Life Wallet and Cigarette Racing. And Randy, this is, you know, as a parent, to see your son go to college and now have the opportunity to enter into an NIL marketing contract, it's got to be really exciting.
You know, yeah, it is, and it's exciting, obviously, for us, because it relieves me of some stress from, you know, helping him out with finances. You know, but I think more importantly is that, you know, these kids now with the Ruiz family and the organization and stuff like that, they're not only making them or giving them the deals, but they're also going to teach them how to handle money, be responsible with it and stuff. You know, they've got a system set up to teach them how to publicly speak and just how to brand themselves and to be a part of something that's going to be big.
You know, as parents, you know, I'm a parent, obviously you're a parent, we can't do everything for our kids. We want to do everything, but we can't do everything. And lots of times it gets to the point where it's like anybody but dad and anybody but mom. And when you sit there and listen to an obviously successful business guy like this, sit there and tell, you know, the kids, hey, I'm doing this NIL deal with you, but I expect a lot from you, and I am going to do a lot more than just write you checks.
Oh, yeah. No, absolutely. It's, as a parent, it's reassuring, you know, that it's not like the old days where it's just money under the table and the kids got the money and then that's it. Mr. Ruiz, you know, during his talk here to all of us, he was real adamant and real firm as far as what he expects from the kids. And it's not just a handout, you know, there's things obviously that they have to do, not just for obligation of the contract, but also to learn how to be successful away from football. So away from football while you're in college and away from football while you're, off season and away from college. And also, you know, really emphasize the importance of relationships, you know, and being yourself and being honest. And again, he really emphasized that he plays by the rules. And that's it. I thought the funny part was that if he didn't like the rule, he'll sue and change it. So, but you know, if you can do that, you can do that, and that's awesome.
Jake's been in the program now for a year, and you've gotten to know a lot of these kids, obviously, and this has all happened for them very quickly. Like, this came out of nowhere. You know, there's a coaching change, there's more community support, there's companies wanting to do NIL deals now and things like that.
Right.
What is all this going to mean just to all these kids?
You know, there's a lot of kids that come from backgrounds, you know, where it's, you know, paycheck to paycheck or week to week as far as, you know, meeting some of the basic needs and stuff. So, you know, there's no doubt that that's going to make a difference, you know, for a lot of those kids. But I think as important or important for those kids come from that background or kids that come from other backgrounds is that it teaches them how to at least a foundation to be successful. At least a foundation that when you have money, how you can also make your money work for you. You know, and that being real and down to earth and being yourself and being honest, how that is part of being successful. And Mr. Ruiz, I mean, he said that several times and very convincingly, and everybody was pretty much listening. And to be honest with you, the kids that I've met, they've been good kids. They really have been. You know, I watched Miami in the 80s, you know, and they were great teams, you know, but everybody knows that, you know, there were some problems off the field and stuff. I think a big difference now is getting the talent, and it seems like they don't have the problems off the field that they've had. So I think it's just obviously a different generation, but still got the great talent.
Coaching change in the program, Mario Cristobal coming in. I assume that you've probably spoken to him by now. And
No, I don't think I haven't spoken to him. I know the kids have.
Yeah.
Yes, and Jake loves him. Jake loves Coach Feld, the strength and conditioning coach. You know, obviously everybody was intimidated before he got here, but not that they're not still intimidated, but. He's a down to earth guy from right here, and he does which I thought was really good. Besides his strength and conditioning, He also does a segment that the kids call mind. I think it's mindset or some with the like sports psychology type thing. You know, and kind of keeping your mind open and not only developing yourself physically, but also mentally, so that when that time comes, you're mentally ready and physically ready. But it's. I mean, I we're here. You know, the coaching staff was that was previous coach staff was here when we got here, and that they recruited us. But it's different now. It's really on a very, very steep upward trajectory right now.
Jake had to deal with adversity the last 6 months. He got hurt. He lost his opportunity to seize the starting job.
Right.
And, you know, obviously Tyler Van Dyke took it and ran with it to an unbelievable level.
Absolutely.
So that kind of is a game changer for Jake a little bit. I mean, he's going to go into spring practice. He's going to compete. But Tyler's got a leg up, you know, let's be honest.
Yeah,
and the roadmap for Jake may have become a little bit different. How committed are you guys as a family, as Jake as a player, to following that roadmap and, you know, sticking with it at Miami?
Tyler, my hat's off to Tyler, man. He's, you know, struggled in the first couple games, you know, in the first half of the first couple games, but he was awesome. He was. We were rooting for him, and real happy, you know, for him and what he was able to do for the team and stuff like that. You know, Jake understands that, you know, just like you just said, he didn't lose the competition to Tyler. He lost because he got hurt. Jake is wired very different than I was ever wired and some other people I know. He's going in there and he's going to compete, you know. And that's I mean he bets on himself, right? So, and yes, Tyler has a leg up and he should, and he rightfully so. And he needs to be the guy to be out. I mean, but I'm also hoping that it's a fair and open competition also, you know. As far as staying here, I have no plans. We sold our house to California,
right.
So we're definitely not moving back to California. We have no plans. We have no plans to leave. I mean, I want him to finish here.
If Tyler puts up a season, if Tyler wins the job,
right,
and keeps the job, and puts up a season this year, like he did the last half of last year, he's going to the National Football League in a few months.
Oh so. Yeah, no, definitely. You know, and that, and from a selfish standpoint, I hope that happens and it's great and he's gone. Right, and he's making millions in the league and does great there. But regardless, we want to win as a team, right? And I know that play some teams that we should be able to do okay with. Even if Tyler's starting, you know, Jake will get some time in. And as a backup, if it turns out to be the backup, I mean, just gotta be ready because you just never know. Look at what happened with Tiger, right? Exactly, and we're looking forward to it.
And Jake's been the prototypical team guy since he arrived on campus. I mean, the kids gravitate to him. He tries to be a leader. He exudes leadership.
Yes, and that's, you know, and that's and he likes that role. You know, he thrives. You know, he thrives in that role. But it also comes natural to him. So we're going to be fine. We like it here. I'm really happy that things have changed. I'm not talking about coaching stuff like that, just in general. And things have changed and just gotten so much better. And like I said earlier, the trajectory is straight up. And we're getting a lot of athletes I'm not sure we would have gotten before.
All right, Randy, it's great catching up with you. Thank you for your insight. And best of luck to you and to Jake as he moves forward here at Miami.
Thank you very much.